Good evening, friends. There's a wonderful word from the Zen tradition, suchness. It represents the world just as it is, and it is a fundamental aspect of reality. If one understands suchness, one can navigate the tumultuous waters of change that our current world is going through. What with artificial intelligence and social media, the breakneck speed at which our world evolves can be dizzying. Now we are experiencing an unprecedented time, a time of almost exponential change. What used to take centuries now happens in decades or even years. The rise of artificial intelligence, for instance, is one of these phenomena. Many fear it. They see an entity not of flesh and blood, capable of thinking, analyzing, learning, and they fear the loss of their own significance. Yet consider this, in our fear, are we not reducing ourselves? Are we not saying that the only thing that makes us important is our ability to think, to reason? But we are so much more than just our minds. We are beings capable of love, of compassion, of experiencing the profound beauty of existence. And here is where suchness steps in. It invites us to experience things as they are, without judgment, without fear. Moving on to social media, a tool that was supposed to connect us all, has sometimes divided us even more. It's easy to forget that behind every profile picture, behind every comment, there is a real, living, breathing human being with their own joys, sorrows, and struggles. The anonymity provided by the internet can often lead us to dehumanize each other. Yet if we approach social media with the understanding of suchness, we realize that just like in real life, behind each user, there's a story, a person who's living their own version of the human experience. It's easy to engage in arguments, to take sides, but once we realize the suchness of people, we begin to see things from a different perspective. We can bring more compassion, more understanding, and more acceptance into these virtual spaces, making them more reflective of our own humanity. Suchness also invites us to remember our own intrinsic value, outside of likes, shares, and followers. It reminds us that we are more than the highlight reels we post online, and that our worth cannot be measured by digital approval. So, don't let yourself be swayed by the turbulent waves of online validation. We must not forget that technology is a tool, and like any tool, its impact depends on how we use it. Our world is changing fast, yes, but if we can face these changes with an understanding of suchness, we can navigate them without fear, without anxiety. Instead of viewing these changes as a threat, we can see them as they are, a part of the ever-changing dance of life. Remember, the essence of Zen is not to escape life, but to fully engage in it, to meet it head-on. And in this dance of suchness, of things just being what they are, we can learn to dance too. So, my friends, in the face of AI, of social media, of any change that comes your way, do not lose yourself. Instead, discover yourself. Embrace suchness and join in the dance.